Hello, welcome back to World Lego Star Wars Complete Saga, where in the last episode we played through the fourth chapter of Attack on the Clones, the Jedi Battle, and so we're going to be playing the fifth chapter, which is Gunship Cavalry. Let's do it. Episode 2, Attack of the Clones. Chapter 5, Gunship Cavalry. The Grand Army of the Republic has been called into action. Led by Mace Windu and Yoda, the new clone forces clash with the separatist droid armies on the planet Geonosis. Obi-Wan Kenobi and Anakin Skywalker engage with the enemy as they pursue Count Dooku and their Republic attack gunship. And we start off almost immediately, basically meaning that there's practically no opening cutscene there. Anyway, so first things first, True Jedi for this level is 30,000 studs, and it is also one of the easiest for collecting mini-kits in the entire game, because they're all pretty much right on the open. The first one's going to be right over here on the left-hand side, and we're going to be collecting 9 mini-kits in this episode, so we're only going to miss one, and we need a TIE Fighter for that. Second one's going to be right in front of you, just like the last one, and then coming up ahead, we're going to need to take a left turn right here, and it's going to be these things right here. These things are little bombs that you can tow with you by pressing the B button right next to it. You can tug it along with you across the battlefield, and we need to do this in order to take it to the other side, or to the end of the battlefield, and drag it into either one of these two statues on either side. We need to knock both of those out in order to drop down the force field so that we can proceed into the next area. So once you do that, you will be good to go. So now I just crashed. So now we just gotta go all the way back over to where we got the bombs the first time, wait for another one to respawn. This time we had one ready. Oh, I just lost control of it. Please don't fall into the pit. Okay, he fell into the abyss. Okay, now I'm gonna have to play the waiting game for a little bit for one to spawn in. There we go. Okay, so now we're gonna tug this all the way. We gotta hit the one on the left this time. And also, there's these turbo lasers hereby. They're not an instant kill. They're just gonna knock out one of your hearts if you hit them. So try not to hit them. You may wanna slow down a little bit if you're trying to get a bomb across one of them. And then the next one coming up is gonna be another, I see it up ahead, our third minikit's going to be right here, and then immediately after that on the right-hand side is going to be a power brick hiding behind this rock right here. There we are, somehow managed to not fall off there. And then our next minikit is going to be in the left-hand side behind a wall that we need to break down, so let's just wait for these to pass. We need to get it past this laser right here, and then take a left turn and roll the bomb into that wall right there to get it to blow up, and then your minikit will be waiting for you on the other side. And there's True Jedi completed. Now all we gotta do is get the bombs to the end of this battlefield to knock out those two statues like we did previously. And then once we knock down the second force field, we'll be able to proceed straight into the next area. Also, if you currently have 4 minikits and a power brick, you do not need to worry about any other minikits for the rest of the level. You'll notice I said that we're going to get 9 in this level, and yet I still just told you that you don't need to worry about it anymore. Why? Well, because the next... Ow, that's going to roll off the edge. Because the next 5 minikits are quite literally right out in the open. It is impossible to miss. Like, it is actually impossible, unless you're blind. Like, unless you're actually blind, it is impossible to miss these, because they are actually just blatantly right out in the open. You have to deliberately not get them. You have to deliberately avoid them in order to not get them. That is how obvious they are. Although, I guess you could say that all of these have been pretty wide out in the open, so what you know is, well, all right, here's this one. Now we gotta get the other statue, so let's head on back and get that bomb. So it's interesting you don't really see your partner. You don't really see your other gunship at all in these levels, unless you're playing... If you're playing co-op, you see them, but if you're just playing single player, then you don't really get to see your... You don't get to see your co-op buddy, and that's... I'm not gonna be like... Oh, wait, I might be able to... Wait, catch the bomb. Catch it! Nice, okay, I caught it before it self-detonated. Okay, make it past these lasers. I'm gonna have to pause here before, because the lasers are gonna reactivate, and then go. I can make a break for it. Go to the left, hard left, and drag it into... No, it ran into the stupid little mouse things. Okay, let's try that again, I suppose. Yeah, sometimes it's better to just take a hit for the lasers rather than trying to wait for them to go away, just because if you are already at, like, one heart, then it's sometimes, like, one other hit will kill you, so you may as well get it over with, and then just reset your hearts. Like, right here, I'm gonna try to destroy myself before I pick up the bomb. Like that, just so that I have full hearts, because I want to be able to, just so I don't have to worry about getting hit by any of the missiles coming up, because you'll notice it's raining missiles. Those things can hit you, they have hit me at least, and that wasn't part of the plan. Okay, go, grab it, got it, nice. And we're gonna have to wait here, but I should be able to make a break for it after these go away. All right, hard left, hard left, hard left. Go around the rock, and swing it into it, just like that. All right, final area. Number 5. Number 6. Number 7. Number 8. So now we're just going to drive in circles and destroy every single enemy in here before you start destroying stuff with the bombs. You want to make sure every enemy in this area is completely dead. Then once that's the case, then you can start knocking stuff out. Okay, I think everything's done. So now what you want to do is you want to head to the bomb dispenser, which is going to be towards the area you spawn in. I think it's right around the corner. Yep, there it is. Okay, head to the bomb dispenser, grab a bomb, and drag it into one of these turbo lasers right here, if I can. That wasn't part of the plan. Okay, that should just roll into it, though. Okay, that's one down. Then grab another bomb from the dispenser and drag it to the turbo laser, the matching turbo laser, because there's two per thing that we're trying to blow open. So drag it to the opposite one, and then once both of them are down, you can also, they just spawn them. Let's get rid of these guys really. You need to blast open those, you need to destroy those three blue things hiding inside. Once you do that, that will be one down. You need to do that for every single one of these. So destroy each pair of turbo lasers and then the blue things hiding inside. And you are not running away from me, bomb. You are gonna, okay, never mind. You are running away from me. Okay, drag into the thing. Thank you. Okay, so these things are back and ready for more. Don't worry, we'll just pull them. But you just want to blow everything up as you see them, because there is a chance your bomb will get, they'll get in the way of your bomb, and you won't be able to destroy the thing you're trying to destroy. So that's not what we want to have happen. So just destroy them when you see them, and you should be fine. All right, we only got a few more to go, so let's carry it around and drag it in here. Is that gonna hit? Yeah, it is. There's another missile dispenser right over here, which is a lot more convenient than the one that's back there, because of course this is closer to these two than the other one. There's that done. Now we can just shoot out these three things. Also, at this point, you should have more than enough for true Jedi, so you don't need to worry about losing too many studs. And, oh, they're back and ready for more, are they? Well, let's fix that problem. There's one, there's one, and there is two. Done. All right. Now the final set. Let's grab bomb number one, drag it into this guy. There we are. Grab another bomb. Okay, never mind. You're going to cause me problems, aren't you? I can already tell that you're going to cause me problems. Let's destroy you right now. And we need to grab this and get that bomb before. Nope, you're not sneaking up on me. Nope, 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 nope. We're flying around you, into the laser. Boom. And destroy those three blue things to finish off the level. Level complete, free play unlocked. Today we unlocked the Exploding Blaster Bolts Power Brick. We unlocked a new vehicle, the Republic Gunship. We of course earned True Jedi and raised the soul stuck on by that value and obtained 9 mini kits. We also earned some gold bricks, one for completing the level, and another for earning True Jedi. And that'll be it for this episode. So, thanks for watching. Stay tuned for next time. I'll catch you all tomorrow for some more LEGO Star Wars Complete Saga. Goodbye!